If you don't know already, you need to pay attention to your children's eyes in pictures, specifically if they have a white or light reflection in one of their eyes compared to the other. This may be a sign of a rare type of eye cancer found in children. In this video, we're talking about a retinoblastoma. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. EyeGuy, with a show that keeps your eyes healthy and your vision clear. And I do videos all about the eyes to help you with your eyes. So make sure you're subscribed for my future videos. Now let's talk about eye cancer. Now if you haven't noticed already, I have the lighting set up. I even dilated my eyes just for you so that you could kind of see the reflection of the light coming out of my pupil. And this is completely normal. Sometimes you'll accidentally get that in pictures. If you have the angle just right and it's kind of a dim environment, the pupils are a little bit bigger, the flash will go off of your camera and that flash will go into the eye where it has vasculature, certain color to it, and the light will bounce back into the camera and you might have that red reflex or a red reflection or a red eye in your pictures. And this is something we as doctors actually can use during an eye exam as we're examining children's eyes or even adult eyes. We can actually see that reflection, that red reflex, to determine if there are any abnormalities in one or both of the eyes. And there are a few things that test can actually tell us. It can maybe tell us if there's a refractive error in one or both eyes, meaning if there's a crazy amount of astigmatism or nearsightedness. It can maybe tell us if there's a micro eye turn or a strabismus in someone's eyes. One reflex might be dimmer or different than the other eye. And something that we're looking for specifically in children is a white or lighter reflex. A white reflex in one of the eyes compared to the other eye. This might be a sign of something called a retinoblastoma. That white reflection that you might see in an eye is called leukocoria, or a white reflex, and that's exactly what you're looking for. Now one quick note here, while you're taking a picture or shining a light inside the eye, the reason why it might look white or have a white reflex is because it hits that retinoblastoma, which is usually a brighter look or brighter appearance, and it will reflect back to the camera. Now you might also get the same white reflection if you get the angle just right and it hits the nerve of the eye. The nerve also has a bright color to it, and sometimes that can cause a brighter or white reflex. A retinoblastoma is actually the most common form of eye cancer found in children, but it is really rare. In fact, only about 200 to 300 new cases of a retinoblastoma is diagnosed in the United States every year. A retinoblastoma is found in the retina of the eye, where all the visual nerve cells are that send the signal back to the brain for vision. And a retinoblastoma usually happens from a genetic mutation that causes cells to multiply and continue to grow where they normally should have died. Now, what happens is this will form a tumor that can spread throughout the eye, and more dangerously can actually spread to other parts of the body, specifically the brain, or even go down the spine. Now, there are a few other signs and symptoms, not just the white reflex in that eye that might have a retinoblastoma. That eye might have an eye turn or a strabismus. It also might be swollen compared to the other eye. That eye also might be red compared to the other eye, and the vision also might be poor compared to the other eye. Now, there are a few explanations to why children actually get a retinoblastoma. One is that it can actually be inherited from one or both of the parents. That genetic mutation can be passed down to the child. Also, that child can also get that genetic mutation themselves. In fact, there's a theory out there called the two-hit hypothesis, where you could inherit that one genetic mutation and the child actually gets a genetic mutation, so it's kind of a double whammy there, and that could cause a retinoblastoma as well. Now usually when it's inherited from a parent, you can get it in both eyes, right eye and left eye. A lot of times if it's just a genetic mutation in the child themselves, then it could be just one eye. Most children that actually get a retinoblastoma are 3 and under. Now the survival rate of a retinoblastoma is actually really good. It's at 96% for a 5-year survival rate, but this depends on how early you actually catch the retinoblastoma. The later you catch it, the more chance it might have spread to the brain and the survival rate will go down. Now, treatment for the retinoblastoma actually depends on the size of the mass or the eye cancer. If it is large and there is a risk that it may spread to the other parts of the body, then the treatment is enucleation. They'll actually take the eyeball out. Now, if the retinoblastoma or the eye cancer is small, or maybe it's in both eyes and small as well, the idea is to preserve vision in that child's eyes. And so there are chemotherapy treatments that they can target that certain mass to try and get rid of the mass as much as possible without getting rid of the eyeball. Now, because early detection of a retinoblastoma is so important, that's why you'll see all these campaigns to help you know what to look for in the pictures of your children's eyes. And normally, if you catch the angle just right, you'll notice a red reflex in their eyes. It's called a red eye in the pictures. And in fact, a lot of programs, cell phones, cameras have a red eye filter or to get rid of that red eye in pictures. Now, you still might get that red reflex in pictures, and if you notice in your children's eyes, if they have one eye that might have a nice healthy red reflex and then one eye might be dim or dark or maybe even white or bright, then that's a sign that there might be something going on. And that's when you don't even want to wait, because early detection is the best. So you want to go right into your eye doctor, have them dilate your child's eyes, look inside their eyes. They can actually do the red reflex test and also determine if there is a difference in the reflection of the eyes. But more importantly, they'll be able to look in the back of the eyes and see if there's something wrong. Now, I actually tried on purpose to get a red reflection in my daughter's eyes and my son's eyes, and it was harder than I thought it was going to be. The cameras nowadays have a really good program to get rid of that red reflex, and it was very difficult, more difficult than I thought. The only way that I could get a slight red reflection in my daughter's eyes was actually using my DSLR camera. If I tried to use my phone, the phone had a pre-flash on it, and the pre-flash would constrict my daughter's eyes, and so I couldn't really see the red reflection. And so I could set up my DSLR camera to not have that pre-flash, and then that flash would surprise her and catch that red reflection coming back from the eye. Now, if you actually want to try this at home, you want to do it in dim lighting so your child's eyes will dilate a little bit, so that'll give you your best chance to see that red reflection. And you want to space yourself. You want to go back about 4 feet and then zoom in on to your child's eyes and then take the picture. Now, what's tricky is you might have a pre-flash or a red eye filter on there that will constrict their eyes and make it really tricky to get that red reflection on there. Usually when I got that red reflection, it was actually on accident where I wasn't trying to get it. I just happened to get that perfect angle, perfect reflection. But yeah, it's pretty tricky. Now, there's a lot more detail that we can go into about a retinoblastoma, but I'll put more links in the description below if you want to find out more information about this type of eye cancer, as well as steps if you want to try and test out the red reflex of your children's eyes. Hey, thanks for watching the whole video. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy. Hopefully this didn't freak you out about having these weird reflections coming out of my eyeballs. I just thought it might be a good demonstration of what to look for. But thanks for watching. Stay focused and check out my other videos right there, and I'll see you in the next video.